Today, my dear students of BA Part 3 English Honours, we are going to discuss about the great Indian novelist R.K. Narayan and his novel, The Bachelor of Arts. Novel writing is a great art that gives a creative artist an opportunity to express himself to his full capacity. The rich Indian culture, its heritage and tradition provides equal chance to a sharp, creative and curious mind to find a breeding ground. Amongst all the Indo-Anglian novelists, that is, those novelists who chose English as their medium of expression, three names stand out: Mulk Raj Anand, R.K. Narayan and Raja Rao. The trio, as they are known, are famous for their novels written during the pre- and post-colonial times. We are going to discuss the novel, The Bachelor of Arts by R.K. Narayan. R.K. Narayan was a man of letters born in the year 1907 in Madras. He was from a Tamilian background and had settled in Mysore, where the regional language is Kannada. Having a South Indian background and a command over the English language, R.K. Narayan has written many novels and short stories depicting the South Indian way of life in details. His art of characterization is very close to reality, and he carries a satirical mood which is far from being pungent or mocking. R.K. Narayan rose to glorious heights, and he was the first person to receive the Sahitya Academy Award. In 1964, he was awarded the Padma Bhushan. In 1985, he was nominated as a Rajya Sabha member. He is also popular in West, and in 1967, he was awarded with an honorary degree of D.Litt by the University of Leeds. The Bachelor of Arts was written in the year 1937, and it is actually a part of a trilogy, that is Swami and Friends, The Bachelor of Arts and The English Teacher. His other popular novels were Waiting for Mahatma, The Guide and Malgudi Days. Some of his short stories too were very popular. An Astrologer's Day is one among the many that he wrote. His novel, The Guide, was made into a popular, successful Hindi cinema, and it brought him immense name and fame. Malgudi Days was also telecast on the national TV. It was Graham Greene who found a publisher for Narayan to publish his novels and stories in English. Thus, through him, Narayan became a known novelist to the West. Narayan and Mulk Raj Anand were often condemned as Indianizing the English language. But how can one distance oneself from one's roots and culture? This was the beauty of Narayan. Writing in a foreign tongue, he still carried the flavors of South India. His Tamilian and Kannada background were intact in his characters, incidents and thought process. The Bachelor of Arts was written in 1937 when India was under the British rule. Writing in a very simple and lucid style, we find no political overtones in his novel. The preface of the novel is written by Graham Greene, who states that the novel is humorous and oddly poignant, and the book that is recommended to all types of readers. The title of the novel, The Bachelor of Arts, is ironical to the journey of life that the protagonist, Chandran, faces. After graduating, Chandran is ill-equipped to face the challenges of life. He experiences many upheavals in his life before finally settling down. Some critics claim the novel to be autobiographical in mode. The novel begins with Chandran's experiences at Albert College, from where he completes his graduation. He is a good debater, and once he accepts to be a prime mover in a debate. Being a history student, he debates on historians should be slaughtered first. In a way, we can say that Narayan disagrees with the historians as he thinks that they distort history. Narayan never steps into any political debate in any of his novels. Chandran's life at the college is busy and full of fun. He comes in contact with Veeraswami and Mohan, and he becomes friendly with them. For Mohan, Chandran has great affinity. Next, Chandran enters in a one-sided affair with Malati, a 15-year-old girl whom he sees by the riverside where he often goes for a walk. They both belong to the same caste, yet their horoscopes do not match. However hard he tries, the marriage does not materialize and Chandran is heartbroken. He mocks at the system of arranged marriage and the superstitious belief of horoscope matching. Narayan was very progressive in his beliefs. He questions at the whole system of marriage, and in one place in the novel, he says, and I say, quote, "Why should we be cudgelled and nose-led by our elders? Why can't we be allowed to arrange our lives as we please?" Unquote. Disappointed and dejected, Chandran leaves Malgudi. For a stint of 8 months, he lives like a sannyasi, an ascetic. Head shaven and draped in saffron robes, he aimlessly wanders from one place to another. He tells the barber who shaves his head, and I quote, "My heart is dead, Raghavan. I have lost everybody I love in this world," unquote. But soon Chandran realizes his state and feels that he has lost normalcy because of the dejection he had faced in his love life. He sobers down and feels composed and finally returns home. And I again quote from the novel, "When Mohan questions him about Malati, he gives a very mature reply. I have trained my mind not to. She is another man's wife now," and unquote. After much effort, Chandran gets the agency of the Daily Messenger, a newspaper. He works hard and gets a lot of subscription. Chandran's father advises him to get married and settled. Initially, Chandran refuses, but after discussing with his friends, he settles for a beautiful girl, Sushila. Chandran enjoys his domestic life and with Sushila. He has sobered down and works hard to develop his business. The entire book is a journey, a transition from adolescence to adulthood. Narayan presents a perfect blend of traditional values and modern thought. Narayan's style is simple and descriptive. Some critics compare him and his narrative skill to that of Guy de Maupassant. The Malgudi town, where most of his novels and stories are placed, is a reminder of Thomas Hardy's Wessex. Graham Greene thought that Narayan was realistic like Antony Chekhov. His humor and compassion in humor could be related to William Faulkner. Narayan is in no way less than any of the European novelists and story writers. His range is limited only to the middle class and the lower middle class that dwell in his imaginary town of Malgudi. But the people are real. Their relationships, their joys and sorrows, their idiosyncrasies are all a part of his novel. He excels in the art of characterization. His characters are individuals, Chandran, Swami, or Raju the guide from his novel Guide. Acclaimed critics like K.R.S. Iyengar and Uma Parmeshwaram find Narayan as a true representative voice of the Indian middle class. The Aam Aadmi, or the common man that we talk about, are his real heroes. Their simple lives with all the trials and tribulations find space in his writings. He builds a connection with his readers, and that is the mastery of his art. Now, I hope, my dear students, that after going through this lecture and reading your text, you will have a very clear understanding of Narayan's works. Thank you.